Yo, what up? Was geht, Dicker? My name is Sanj, and today we are back with another video. And as you can see from the slightly different background than the usual, I'm still getting settled in, and from the new intro, this is a glimpse of the pad in Berlin. As the title suggests, today we're going to be talking about the stuff that I picked up whilst I was in LA and that I managed to bring home with me. Vintage, designer, accessories, friends brands, we've got a whole bunch here. Hopefully you're going to enjoy this one, and let's get straight into... Oh, also, prior to me jumping into it, this is going to be a mixture of like a vlog style plus me talking about the pickups, because I managed to film some bits whilst I was out there as well. Pieces everywhere. Unsound Rags, as I'm sure many of you guys know about, my boy Fernando and his team sort of curate it and look after it, and you know, some might say that it's one of the most well curated, does that even make sense? One of the best curated vintage stores out in LA. And this basically is a simple family reunion tee, just says the Morgan. It's on a jerseys blank in a size XL, single stitch. And then numero due, we have another vintage tee. This one says Pistol Parlor. This was the t-shirt that I was wearing in the previous video during my intro and my outro. But yeah, Unsound Rags, $40 I believe. Once again, single stitch. Just needed some t-shirts, so I got it. And then we're moving on to the outerwear section of what I picked up at Unsound, and this is the banger. So it's a USAF MA2 bomber jacket from the 70s, supposedly. The wash and the fade, I don't know if you can see that, but hopefully the on-body will do it justice. It's absolutely insane. It fits incredible. It fits like a size a medium. On the tag, I believe it says size medium as well. So yeah, fits fairly true to size, which is surprising on a piece from, you know, the 70s, because normally back in the day, anything that would say medium would actually fit more like a small. No crazy detailing. It's just purely for the cut and the wash, like no prints or anything like that. But the cut and the wash alone makes this piece an absolute showstopper. Next up, we have the sponsors of today's video, and that is Jade Black. The wonderful people over at Jade Black actually sent me 3 pairs of sunglasses. If you saw any of my stories, or actually in a previous video, these were the pairs that I was wearing. And man, I'm actually baffled. Like, and I know that people have a negative connotation whenever you get any sponsored content, people are kind of on the back foot. Can you believe it? Can you not? Truth be honest, I don't really care whether you believe me or not. These are absolutely bangers. They cost $49. And the quality in them is absolutely insane. Okay, so let me show you the 3 pairs of sunglasses that I had chosen. This is frame numero uno. Obviously, these are very much inspired by some of the more iconic frames, but for such a price point, considering that all of them come with polarized lens. Then number 2, my personal favorite, perhaps because it's the most low-key one, that is that we've got a slight bit of silver detailing. That you guys know that I love my silver, so I opted for the frames that had some silver detailing. Obviously they have frames that have gold detailing, so that is worth taking a look too. So that is numero due, fashionable offering out of the bunch. This number right here, it's just so sick, man. And legit, $49, are you dumb? Are you dumbzo? Obviously, they blessed the boy with a discount code, which will be plastered right here on the screen and in the description box down below for you guys to make use of. Also, if you are based in New York, J Black have actually partnered with Away, I believe. I think that's how you pronounce it, where you can basically get a same day delivery. So stock up, $49, polarized, using all sorts of high quality material like acetate, Teflon, and stainless steel. Grab yourself some steels. Black Friday, 50% off. Get a free pair when you purchase three. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to stock up. I know that they sell out super quickly, so do be on the case if you wish to grab some. Links will be in the description box down below. Do check them out. I want to say a huge thank you to the sponsors, obviously, because they make these videos happen and allow me to kind of continue creating on this platform. So thank you, Jade Black, and thank you, you guys, because without you guys, there would be no Jade Black wanting to work with me. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Damn, fucking insane piece.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really it. Like, you know, not even like the big awesome mask. Now, after visiting Unsound Rag, I went to see Justin Reed, and man, this guy has the craziest, or one of the craziest selection. The warehouse was just beautiful, extremely well curated, decorated. Incredible pieces, literally wherever you look, there's like a banger. And I was able to kind of sift through some of the pieces. I was on a bit of a time constraint, so I couldn't really take my time and show you guys everything that I wanted to show you. But you know, we got a tiny glimpse of it. He doesn't really do appointments unless it's like word of mouth or private. So I'm very thankful that he even allowed me to come in and kick it and, you know, get to speak to him, see the pieces and everything. And I managed to pick up one item which I had my eyes on for a while. It was on my Grailed wish list. I was able to go there, try it on, make sure that it fits me, and then grab it. And it is the Calvin Klein 205W39NYC fireman jacket in the black colorway. So as some of you guys may recall, I have the orange colorway, and this is the black iteration, and it's actually a longer cut. It's just a fire fucking piece. No pun intended. It's just an amazing piece. Pocket detailing, the fireman jacket enclosure that can be found at the front. We've got two huge voluminous pockets. Then one crazy detailing that I like, I'm gonna come up real close to the camera, is the zipper here that can be found on the sleeves. And what it does is it can actually be worn open, so you can wear it sleeveless. The sleeve just kind of dangles along, which is a cool little stylistic touch. Should you wish to have that in the back, we have a very minimal Calvin Klein 205W39NYC branding, black on black, and we have the yellow and silver stripes are going along. This is a size small, fits kind of big, it fits me really nicely. Granted, I'm not going to be able to wear a ton of layers underneath it. So that is that from the boy Justin Reed. Thank you so much for blessing me with this. I mean, I did pay for it, but you know, he was able to hook me up and look after me whilst I was in the warehouse. So I'm very, very grateful. And it's definitely one of those spots that I know for sure that I'll be revisiting the next time I'm in LA. And hopefully this time with a lot more time. And maybe I could even take you guys along with me, because that would be fantastic. This is the Crescent Moon jacket from the boy Gizmo, his brand's Come Aware. Absolutely incredible. Now, I haven't shown it on the channel, but I did purchase the grey version, the sort of V1 iteration of this jacket, and now this is the V2 in this beautiful green colorway. Now, there was a lot of changes that took place, primarily on the inside of the garment when it comes to construction detailing, and there is a new sort of little bit here that was added to kind of aid with mobility on the jacket. Beautiful cut, longer on the front, and then in the back you have a bit of a crop which kind of creates a crescent shape when worn, and I'm sure you will see it on the on body, which I will be sure to include. Sizing, Gears only releases things in two sizes, at least for the time being, I believe, medium and a large. I went with a large. Be honest with you, if you're a small, go for Giz's medium, and if you're a medium, go for his large, and you should be good to go. Two pockets at either side, a Cagney zipper with a double pull or double head, basically, so you can create some funky little designs with your zippers should you wish to do so. You've got one pocket on the inside, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful piece, man. Absolutely fucking smashed it. Now, unfortunately, I believe that this might already be sold out. So sorry about that, but hey, you can find it on the secondhand market, or if he does decide to do any restocks. Alrighty, Roo, we're gonna jump in with the man, the myth, the legend. I mean, I'm sure they will know you, but if you want to give yourself a tiny quick intro.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Giz. Yeah, also known as Gizmo the
Goat
with two T's. Yes.
And so I've already shown you guys some of the pieces, well, at least I hope that I've already shown you guys some of the pieces. Now, this is one of the newer silhouettes that you're releasing.
My balloon jacket.
That I absolutely love. Yeah. That I was blessed to have slightly earlier than everyone.
Slightly earlier.
So talk us through, obviously, we've spoken about it just briefly, but the inspirational piece, or like what elements of garments, because I know you refer to a lot of vintage pieces as
well.
Yeah, so. And pull references from there, so.
Basically, when I was in Tokyo, I was vlogging, I was referencing shop a lot of vintage items, and I came across this like G9 Harrington jacket. I'm pretty sure Sandra's gonna put up a photo here. A lot of designers actually work with this silhouette a lot. Obviously, I think Demna, the famous, he worked this on his 2017 SS collection with exaggerated shoulders. Still, he worked with the cotton fabric. But for me, before this drop, I think most of my garments was made from cotton, because I wanted to, because it's more obvious, easily to wear in every day.
100%.
But then for this drop, I wanted to play with different fabrics. Mm-hmm. So for me, I naturally wanted to go for this like viscose blend fabric.
Okay.
So that was the fabric choice for it. But yeah, it essentially started from this G9 Harrington jacket that I picked up while I was in Tokyo.
Now, what made you want to
tweak the details?
Tweak, especially for me, it's the ballooning effect of it that I really love from that jacket.
Yeah.
Where did that come from? Or were you just like, you know, reworking your G9 and you were like, that would actually look cool?
Yeah, because for me, obviously, people who follow me or my girlfriend, like, we like to play with a lot of silhouettes, and we like, you know, just like intricate details and like those, just like volumes and drapes and like darts and those kind of things.
Yeah.
It's kind of like my bread and butter. So I wanted to play with that. And because I think the classical Harrington jacket, the G9 jacket, it's more casual wear, I think, you know what I mean? But I wanted to make something like kind of more luxe, on the luxe
way.
But then the problem is like, where do you find the balance? If you make a luxury garment, then I don't want it to be a piece where you just wear occasionally.
Yeah.
For me, I always like to wear my pieces. When I buy a pieces, I want to wear it as much as possible.
Right, 100%.
So it needs to be like easy to wear as well.
Yeah. And I think, sorry to cut you off, I genuinely think you smashed that on this one, because yes, the fabric is super beautiful and elegant, and just, it looks like a luxurious product, but I'm not afraid to wear that every day. And just, I have been wearing it a few times now whilst I'm in LA.
Right.
And a perfect blend, I think.
And I'm pretty sure you'll know better, because obviously you'll collect higher Ackerman pieces, which is also known to make a lot of these satin or like this viscose bomber jackets.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But that's really more in the luxe side, I would say. It's like super luxurious and everything. So for me, it was like, okay, then how do I, after getting the silhouette, how do I make it more sporty and everything?
Yeah.
And for me, I've recently like recent days, I'm kind of into like this color blocking.
Gotcha.
Okay, color blocking. So yeah.
We'll edit that in. We'll make it experience.
So yeah. So there's just like this upcoming pants that I didn't show you. That's also like color blocked as well. Sick. So I was like, while I was working, I was like, okay, I need to color block this. Yeah. So I think the first samples that you guys saw
was red on red.
Red on red, and it was a black on the black one. But then after I made the final sample, that was gonna be the final sample, and I was keep looking at it, and I always like give it a few days and sometimes a few weeks to actually like,
wear it and kind of feel it.
I don't know, something felt missing, like that 2%. I was keep looking, and I was like, what's missing? I was like, maybe if I panel this, I was restarted the sample again, like where do I? I'm not sure if you caught this part.
Yeah, yeah, of course. I was really looking at every single detail that's gone. Because you're so detail driven. Yeah. And that truly does, it sounds like I'm fucking licking your arsehole here, but like, it's like.
This is really what I'm trying to do. Like,
I do see that in your work. And I'm like, I've always said this, it's like, it's beautiful pieces. It might not be the most fucking avant-garde, like crazy, whatever, but I know that the detail and the construction is going to be on point, and it's always something that I can look forward to, you know? So, exactly. But yeah, the paneling with the black.
Yeah, so I was like, I need to panel it. So I did try the red on red paneling because I like to go with similar tones. For that one, I realized it might have looked good in the pictures, but when I saw it in real person, the colors kind of offset each other. So it kind of killed the main color. So I was like, in that case, I'm just going to go for the black.
Yeah.
It's going to look sick
anyway. I'm so glad you
tried it. Yeah.
It's so fire.
So fire, right?
So good.
How the paneling worked. And this paneling idea, I guess, would. You know those like Air Jordan track tops?
Mm-hmm.
Like
track
tops?
That's where that's from.
Yeah. So it's kind of like mixed in between those things, and it led to this, I guess, balloon jacket.
Yeah.
This panel.
Were you designing, because obviously this has a sort of similar curvature.
Yeah.
Were you designing them together? Or?
I was designing them together.
Gotcha.
I was
designing. So this so also
kinda like that.
On.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah, it's kind of like that.
Now's the plug part. This one, by the time this video releases, it might actually be already available and sold out. So you have the two colors, the red version here,
the black and navy,
black version.
Black and navy one.
How come you mix black and navy?
It's the forbidden color for me.
Okay.
That was the fun part.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
I fucked with
no, that. Because I don't, so this is the thing, like, it started as a joke and then it kind of cut me. I don't like navy dominated pieces. Like, if it was a navy on black, then I would have wished it to be black. As a consumer, I would have wished it to be a black
navy.
On a navy.
Yeah.
So it's not like I hate navy. I have a lot of navy clothes, but they kind of got out of the picture. I call it the forbidden color.
Sick, man. It's so good. If it's still available, it'll be linked in the description box down below. God knows when this video will go up, but there's a high chance that it will be sold out and gone to many happy customers around the world.
Hopefully so.
Right, fucking smash that. Thank you so much for jumping in.
Thank you.
Very brief moment. And yeah, man.
Cheers.
Finally, the link up.
And yes.
So many more to come as well.
Yes, sir.
Next up, we have two jackets from another brand that was actually sent to me. So grateful. They didn't even ask to be included in the YouTube video. I'm just putting it in there because they're just so sick. And if you follow my boy Greg and Torre, then you would have seen him breaking down one of these pieces on his channel as well, but they sent me a different colorway. So here is me showing it. We have this incredible jacket from AA Spectrum, and I believe this colorway is called the Powder Blue. Boys, it can be found on SNN on their website, which I'll be sure to leave a link in the description box down below. Obviously, this is just, it's just so fucking sick, man. There's just no other way for me to break it down. Sizing, this is a size medium. In the back, we have two zips, which kind of allows you to create and change the silhouette of the garment. If you undo the zip, then there is some fabric underneath, which kind of allows you to make the garment a bit bigger, especially width-wise. And then you also find some zips on the sleeve detailing, which kind of, again, same concept, there's some fabric underneath it, so should you wish to have the sleeves a bit wider, you may do so. Now, this is a cut that is very interesting, at least for me, because I don't tend to gravitate towards these pieces normally, when the collar is a simple, like, circle, basically. A collarless jacket is something that I don't tend to gravitate towards, just because I never think they fall right. However, they have done a tremendous job. This is definitely a jacket that I think looks best layered, especially with a hoodie. I have worn it without. Looks great, but with a hoodie, looks better, at least in my opinion. The texture of this jacket is absolutely insane, and it is perfect for this upcoming fall winter season. Now, you have two huge pockets at either side of the body. I'm so fucking hyped to start with this, man. You're gonna see the on bodies and beauty, 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 beauty. I'm super thankful. Thank you to the wonderful people over at AA Spectrum for blessing me with this and sending it over. Now, the second piece, again, an absolute banger. I just got it in the wrong size, and unfortunately they're out of a size medium. So I got this in a size large, and it is their Mongolian jacket in the sort of green olive colorway. And it's just fucking insane. Look at it. You're gonna see it on body. It's fucking massive. It literally drowns me. It's hella, hella warm. Beautiful piece, just way, way too big. Like, don't get me wrong, there's oversized, which I think the powder blue jacket does really well, for example, and then there's just straight up too big, and this is one example of that. Now, I've already found a very good home for this jacket. If you follow my boy Kelly, then he is the lucky recipient of it, and I'm very much looking forward to seeing how he's gonna style it. But yeah, absolutely incredible jacket. Once again, this can be found, I believe, on Essence, amongst other retailers, and their own website, which will be linked in the description box down below. We have some really fucking cool embroidered detail that can be found all along the sort of collar detail, and this part, I don't know what this part is called. Then on the sleeve as well, I turned it out, just because it was too long for me, but that's some of the embroidered detail that you can see. The construction detailing on both these jackets is absolutely incredible. Now, I've seen my boy Greg wear these jackets for a while now, and I was always intrigued by them, so I'm so glad that they reached out and we're able to do something together. So thank you, AA Spectrum. I'm gonna wear the shit out of that powder blue jacket, and Kelly will hopefully wear the shit out of this Mongolian jacket, which is unfortunately just way, way too big for me. But we are going to move on to the final piece, the absolute just disgusting banger of this video. It's going to be the creme de la creme. Is insane. Okay, first of all, I would have never fucking bought this piece if it wasn't for the fact that we went to Vegas and your boy managed to do really well. Not like crazy, crazy well, but you know, for someone that has only been to Vegas 3 times, including the last one, 2 of those times I lost. I did well in this one. So I decided to treat myself with this jacket from Mr. Rick Owens. It is the Keith jacket in the green pony and white shirling. Now, this jacket is very reminiscent of the Grinch. Bro, fucking insane. I mean, you're gonna see it on the on-body anyway. The detailing, the construction, absolutely fire. I went into the Rick Owens stores to check out something else entirely, actually. I wanted to take a look at the Kiss Heels with the pony hairs, the thigh high Kiss Heels pony hair, but they didn't have those in stock. And then I came across this piece, and at first I was like, wow, it's fucking insane, but you know, I didn't even bother trying. Then as I went to leave the store, I was like, fuck it, let me just give it a go. And it was the last one in a size 50, which is my size when it comes to Rick Owens. An absolute beauty, kind of cropped in the body. It's not the super cropped version. Women's wear have another version, which is insanely cropped. Primarily consistent of the green pony hair. I don't actually think it's pony hair, but you know, that's what it's being referred to on the website. And then white shirling. And you have a tiny bit of a black detailing that can peek through if you leave the sort of top neck bit open. But that is going to conclude the pieces that I managed to grab whilst I was in LA, with this one just fucking finishing the whole thing. Just look at it, an absolute perfection on a garment. I'm so gassed about it. And I know that one, hopefully it's a piece that I'm gonna keep in my wardrobe for a while and get a lot of wear out of it. Two, when I do get bored of it, I know that it can retain its value, because some of the Keith jackets on secondhand platforms like Grailed and eBay, crazy money. And this one is fucking fire. So that is that for this video. It's been a long time. I'm slowly, you know, getting back into the swing of things. There's so many fucking bloopers in this video, which you obviously won't see. But yeah, thank you for your continuous support and love. I wanna say a huge thank you to the wonderful people over at Jade Black for sponsoring this video. I'm actually gonna end the video with me Sonny's on. As I mentioned, they're $49 a pop, plus I have an extra discount code that can be found on the screen right now. If you buy three over Black Friday, you get the fourth pair for free. And these are absolute bangers. Comes in a variety of styles and sizes, and you know, you can tweak the lenses and whatever. So definitely do go check them out. I wanna say a huge thank you to those guys as well for allowing this video to happen. Yeah, if you wish to find me on social media, it's all right here. S-A-N-G-I-E-V, that is for Twitter, Instagram, and wherever else you may find me online. Thank you for your continued support. If you like what you saw, then don't forget to leave a thumbs up, share, subscribe, and do all that other jazz. I believe that's it for me. If there's more, then, you know, I shall see you next week, or in a couple days, actually, because I need to talk about my next drop that is upcoming. With that being said, have a beautiful day. Take care. Peace.